I'd like to call to order the 21st regular meeting of the 2017-2018 Common Council. Would the clerk please read the quote for the day?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The best journeys answer questions that in the beginning you didn't even think to ask.
Thank you very much. Please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next item on the agenda is the approval of the minutes from our last Common Council meeting. Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to approve.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the minutes? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Next is a presentation on the fourth quarter strategic plan action items and critical measures review by our City Administrator Daryl Huffland.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Tonight I would like to share with you the State of City presentation. It's a recap of activity for 2017 and goals for 2018. The city had another successful year in 2017. I'd like to thank each and every city employee for their contribution in making it happen. My presentation will be organized to reinforce the city's 2017 adopted strategic plan. I'll be asking Meredith to advance the slides as we go along. Meredith, if you want to go to the mission statement. The mission statement, again, was approved in the January 2017 adopted strategic plan. I'll let you read that. Also, as part of that strategic plan was the city's vision statement. Next slide. On your desk is a copy of the status of the strategic plan's 2017 action items, again, for the full calendar year 2017, as well as the critical measures. For action items and critical measures that were successfully completed or accomplished, you'll note that they are printed in blue on your sheets. As you can see, almost all of the items are, in fact, blue. For items not completed, most of them are black printed, and most involve other government or nonprofit agencies. Next slide, please. The six focus areas are as follows: quality of life, infrastructure and public facilities, economic development, neighborhood revitalization, governing and fiscal management, and finally, communication. Next slide. First of the six focus areas is quality of life. For 2017 accomplishments, Skate Park and Kiwanis Park, age-friendly community designation by ARP and World Health Organization, RFID inventory system at Mead Library, no fire-related deaths of our citizens, value of fire loss in 2017 is down 65% over 2016 level, 1.2 a million compared to only 400,000 in 17. Additional school resource officer assignment, implementation of body cameras for our police officers, and uniquely, all three elected officials, the mayor's office, the attorney's office, and the clerk's office, had a 50% turnover of their staff, resulting in a loss of significant institutional experience. So that's a challenge for all of those three departments. Next slide, please. In 2017, the community experienced a 33% drop from its 2013 level of property crimes, already a low level. Next slide, please. In 2017, the community experienced a further 20% decrease in violent crime rates over the past 2 years and a 10% decrease since 2013. For 2018 goals for quality of life, they include a comprehensive fire department review by a consultant, repair of fire station number one building, and ordering a replacement fire engine, which you've recently approved. For police, is focus on traffic safety and accident reduction. Clerk's office will implement new voting machines. And finally, senior activity center will create and conduct a survey targeting 50 and older age 50 and older residents, as well as developing a marketing plan to increase seniors' awareness of the center's offerings. Next slide. The second focus area is infrastructure and public facilities. 2017 accomplishments include IT's five-year plan, including priority staffing levels, refurbishment of the 8th Street Bridge. Next slide. Additional highlights include nearly 33,000 linear feet of improved street surface in 2017. This is a 150% increase in linear feet compared to 2014, whether it be street reconstruction or pavement overlays. Next slide. The city has turned the corner in its pavement quality as measured by the PASER rating system. Again, an increase of roughly 3% over the prior year. Next slide. Another component to the city's infrastructure is tree planting, both street trees and park trees. Almost a 2,000% increase in 2017 over prior year levels. This becomes even more of a priority for the city as we deal with the emerald ash borer devastation in our community. For infrastructure and public facilities 2018 goals, it includes replacement of a wastewater treatment plant main electrical system, including construction of a related building, coordinate Sheboygan A's replacement field lighting, coordinate with our partner, Lakeshore United Soccer Club on the Boots and Sports Complex, and finally, started the City Hall renovation project to be completed in 2019, are all goals. Meredith, next slide, please. Economic development is the third focus area. 2017 accomplishments include completing of the City Green, kickoff of the Innovation District with Indiana Avenue properties being purchased, and finalizing a master redevelopment plan for the area. Annexation of Town of Wilson land in anticipation of a golf course, purchase and annexation of land for the new business park adjacent to I-43. Complete the downtown parking study with no significant deficiencies identified. Completed a federal compliance audit of the transit with no findings. Next slide. In Sheboygan, housing demand is the strongest since 2019. Based upon the 2016 residential property sales prices, a 6% increase in overall residential value in our community over the 2015 level. This results in a $95 million increase in the city's overall value. This follows, unfortunately, a six-year decline in value, 16%, which equates to a $353 million decrease in our community. So a significant change is starting to occur in the city of Sheboygan. Next slide, please. The city's effort to grow its tax base in redevelopment area continues to be successful. Over the past 5 years, the value of the city's 11 TID districts have increased by 23%. It will further increase due to construction that's occurred in 2017 and planned for 2018. Of 490 additional apartments in the city's downtown or Sheboygan Square business district. For 2018 goals revolving economic development, they include construction and marketing of the new I-43 business park, support the development or redevelopment of the Tannery or Coakley property, complete 2018-2022 transportation development plan for Shoreline Metro, discuss the creation of an agreement with Sheboygan Area School District for student passes. Pursue an increase in our ISO rating from 2 to 1, which will result in lower property insurance premiums for commercial and industrial properties. Next slide. The fourth focus area is neighborhood revitalization. Next slide. One of the strategic plan's goals: concerted effort to focus resources on strengthening and improving neighborhoods. City and community efforts include two neighborhood beat officers assigned both to the north and south side, city staff partnering with neighborhood volunteers to create associations, 7 to date, a neighborhood project Rock the Block, which was partnered with Habitat for Humanity, and the addition in 2015 and followed up in 2017 of code enforcement officers. Next slide. As a result of hiring these code enforcement officers, the number of enforcement actions have increased by 293% over the past 4 years. In 2017, the city achieved an 80% compliance rate on these enforcement actions. Next slide. I'm sorry, if you could go back. So for the Neighborhood Revitalization 2018 goals, they include 4 additional neighborhood associations, neighborhood target areas. These neighborhoods are Sheridan Park, Swift, Gateway, and Erie Hill. Next slide. The fifth focus area is governing and fiscal management. In 2017, the city received 2 awards by national organizations. This reflects positively on the professionalism of your city staff. Other 2017 achievements include all non-represented employees are now on a merit pay-based performance program, a revised compensation plan driven by market comparisons to retain and recruit staff. Next slide. Goal setting and monitoring the city's fund balance is critical. The minimum goal for the city is 25% of its general fund to retain the city's excellent credit rating. The city's end of 2017 fund balance is anticipated to be double its goal, or 53%. Next slide. Managing the city's debt is also critical. The city's outstanding debt continues to be stable. In comparison to the debt goal of being no more than 60% of its statutory debt capacity, the city is only at 27%. Next slide. In light of its effective debt management and improving local economy, the city has earned a solid AA2 rating. On a related note, this past week, Moody's Credit Service reaffirmed the Water Utilities AA2 credit rating. So congratulations to Joe Trueblood, superintendent of the Sheboygan Water Utility, and his staff. For 2018 goals for governing and fiscal management, they include revising performance evaluation forms, creating a succession plan for each city employee, and changing how city earn their vacation time. Other 2018 goals include hiring a replacement finance director for our retiring finance director, submit and obtain a CAFR review, a comprehensive annual financial review for award consideration, and updating our strategic plan 2019 to 2020 action items. Next slide. Our sixth and final focus area is communication. Next slide. In 2016-2017, 3 new initiatives were implemented to improve communication with Sheboygan businesses and its residents: a citizen engagement program, an electronic monthly newsletter, and an annual community survey. Next slide. The city continues to increase its interaction with its residents and businesses via social media outlets. Consequently, the number of followers or users continues to grow. 2018 goals in the area of communication focus on creating a strategic communication plan and a review of our existing logo with possible amendments. On your desk, I have placed schedules for four critical processes. One is an update of our community survey and issuance, our strategic plan update, 2019-2023 capital improvement plan, 2019 budget schedule. Please note that a committee of the whole meeting is scheduled to update the strategic plan action items on April 23rd at 6 p.m. This concludes my 2018 State of the City presentation. Feel free to contact me if you have any questions about the information that I have presented. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much, Darrell. I need to take a step back and notice that we have 13 alderpersons present, and Alderperson Bourne, Bitters, and Lee Wendelski are all excused tonight. Next, we'll move on to resignations. City Attorney?
We have one, and that's Mike Helmke, and he is resigning from the Transit Commission.
Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to accept and file.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. And next, we'll move on to mayor's appointments, and those will lie over till our next meeting. Moving on to public forum. Is anyone here to speak this evening?
There is no one here this evening.
Okay. And then we'll move on to mayor's announcements. I'd like to ask Sue Richards to step forward. It's interesting to have her as a guest in the council chambers. Sue Richards began her journey with the city of Sheboygan on March 30th of 1998. Throughout that time, she has filled many different roles. Sue has been council licensing clerk, deputy city clerk, and finally city clerk. As city clerk, Sue has been instrumental in keeping our city running smoothly. As the hub of information and record keeping, Sue always was the source for people to turn to. One of the most memorable things about Sue was her office. Her office was always open to everyone and quite comfortable. If you needed information or had a question or wanted an archived document or a book to read or just a comfy place to sit and vent, Sue's office was the place to go. Her goal was to bring people together for the good of each other and for the city. One of the areas in Sue's tenure that the city clerk often met many interesting challenges was with elections. From a year in which the city ran 7 elections, a presidential election in which voters were lined up from the second floor out the door to vote, to training hundreds of poll workers on new voting equipment, Sue always found a way to make the best of every situation. She took pride in all that she did in her job and did it extremely well. But it wasn't just a job to her. As she stated on many occasions, she felt like those of us in City Hall were family. She created a culture in that office, and it extended throughout the city. Whether it be hosting a holiday dinner, decorating Molly the Bunny, ensuring the citizens of Sheboygan were provided with the finest customer service, and that everyone was always treated with respect and kindness. When the clerk's office asked for people to share their thoughts about Sue, people had so many positive words for her. Some of the words included, "It was always a pleasure to take refuge in your office." "It takes many people to run a city. You have done your part well." "All of the laughs and stories we shared on crazy election nights are going to be held close to my heart." "You have been a great role model, and I will always remember the professionalism, integrity, and kindness that you demonstrated daily." It's only fitting, and the perfect way to sum up Sue's career as city clerk is with a quote. "A true leader has the confidence to stand alone, the courage to make a tough decision, and the compassion to listen to the needs of others." She did not set out to be a leader, but it becomes one of the equality of her actions and the integrity of her intent. Sue, you will continue to be deeply missed, and we want you to have a great retirement. And it's with a great deal of regret that you're leaving that I have to submit you this certificate of appreciation from the City of Sheboygan to Susan Richards. This certificate of appreciation is in recognition of your 20 years of dedicated service from March 30th of 1998 through January 6th of 2018. Sue, thank you very much for everything you've done for this city.
This is a new place for me to be. Thank you, Mike. I don't know if you all know this, but Mike and I have been very good friends for as long as I've lived here, which is well over 30 years. It's been 5 administrations I've been through, 5 mayors, many aldermen, and it has been a journey. It has been a journey. I've always told people that I absolutely love my job, love what I do. I was thinking about it on the way over, what I wanted to say to you all, and we are an office that offers an open door. I mean, it's open door. People come, whether it's an alder person or other staff or just the public. We offer the sense that they are important, they're valuable, and we care about what they need and want. And if that means helping somebody get a phone number in the phone book for them because they don't know how to do it themselves, that's what we're here for. We are here for service to the public, to each other. We don't have a lot of turnover at the clerk's office, very rarely. We have had quite a few in the last handful of years. And I was thinking about our process of how we hire, and because we don't do it very often, I decided to take a different approach on how I hire, and I had my entire staff interview the people coming in. It wasn't just me, it wasn't just someone that really didn't know what our office is all about, and we interviewed hundreds of candidates for the different positions. And one of the first things that I said as we all sat there, and they're all sitting there very nervous, scared of being interviewed, I said to them, just so you know, this is a different office. This isn't your typical office. What we care about, we can teach you everything you need to know to do in the city clerk's office. We can teach you anything, but what we can't teach you is integrity and compassion, kindness, humor, and a love for people. We can't teach you that. And in that event, several people kind of fell away from the list of the top few. And then we had these wonderful people that I still call them mine, rose to the top of the heap. And it was so obvious that Cheryl obviously has been with me forever. And Melissa rose to the top. She had never been in an interview like that in her life. She didn't know that that happened. And then, of course, there's Meredith. They are my family. All of you have touched my life. And I feel a bit lost right now without my family. To be perfectly honest, everybody's asking me, how do you feel now that you're gone? And I keep saying, I don't know, because I feel like I've walked away from my family, and that's hard, but I am going to reinvent myself. And I'm going to take with me all of the love that you have all shown me and the respect. And I can't say enough about my staff. You will still get the wonderful, wonderful care and consideration from these beautiful ladies. And I take this all with me when I go on to this new chapter in my life. And I will just close by saying something that one of my friends in the audience says an awful lot every Monday morning at the department head meetings, that it's an honor, it's been an honor and a privilege to work with all of you. Thank you very much.
Couple other things I'd like to bring up. Our spring primary is coming up on Tuesday, February 20th. The cross-country ski trails are groomed again. I want to thank the JC grooming crew for their work to get those open so quickly. And I also want to remind people that the Sheboygan Police Department is having a police academy, and it's going to be an 11-week program, and the final date to sign up for that is February 23rd. So if you're interested, call the police department or send your application in. It's a great experience. Thank you. Next, we'll move on to the consent agenda. That'll include items 2.3 through 2.13. Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to accept and file all ROs, accept and adopt all RCs, and pass all resolutions and ordinances.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the items in the consent agenda? Alderperson Bellinger.
Thank you. I'd like to pull 2.9 for a separate vote.
Very good. 2.9 is before us then. Did you have anything you'd like to say?
Yes, I just have several questions I'd like somebody to answer. I'd like to know exactly where this wetlands is in the business park, why we weren't notified of it originally. Was Rukert Milkey aware of it? And when they put their plan together, did they try to avoid this so that we wouldn't have to incur this additional cost? You know, those types of things. I'd like it addressed, not only for myself, but for the public so they can see what's going on and be as transparent as possible.
Chad Pelichick is coming up to the podium to answer those questions.
This wetland was identified as part of a wetland mitigation study. Actually, it was 1.6 acres of wetlands that was identified that needed to be mitigated, and staff told them that wasn't acceptable, so they went back and redesigned and moved some of the roadways in order to make the minimal impact possible to the 0.6 acres. There's no way of where the wetland is right where the main north-south road goes, and there's no way of mitigating that with changing the road layout without affecting major portions of developable properties. So we looked at it as staff and determined that this was the minimalist impact to the wetland and to the roadway to yet maximize development for the future.
Thank you.
Does that answer your questions?
Yes.
Okay.
Is there any other discussion on the consent agenda? Seeing none. Will the clerk please call the roll for passage?
Hold that one. Hold off. We have to vote on that one first. He pulled it off.
Okay. Did you want to vote on this one separately, John, or just discuss it?
The discussion is fine. Whatever's easier.
Okay. So then we're voting on the entire consent agenda. That where the motion was to include items 2.2 through 2.13. Motion passes. Next, we'll move on to reports of officers. Items 3.1 through 3.12 will be referred to various committees. Under resolutions, item 4.1 is resolution number 130 of 1718 by Alderpersons Wolf and Drawn, authorized retaining outside counsel in the matter of Eric Burroughs versus Joel Clark and Cameron Stewart. Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to suspend and pass resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Alderperson Bellinger.
Could we get an explanation of why we have the need to suspend?
I can do that. It's included in the resolution, as you asked, as will be the other one.
That's for the public?
Sure. It's because we need to get this done right away. We have to file an answer immediately. Yeah. There's only a 20-day opportunity for filing an answer.
Okay.
It's actually already been done because the council met in 21 days rather than 20.
Thank you. Is there any other discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll? Motion passes. Items 4.2 through 4.4 will be referred to various committees. Under reports of committees, item 5.1 will lie over. Under 5.2, it's RC number 225 of 1718 by the Finance and Personnel Committee, to whom is referred resolution number 124 of 1718 by Alderperson Wolf, supplementing resolution number 100-0506 and awarding the sale of $4.825 million in Water Utility Revenue Bonds Series 2018 and providing for the payment of said bonds and other details and covenants with respect thereto, and recommends passing the resolution. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to accept, adopt, and pass the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Under discussion, I'd like to call up Carol Wirth to give us a little bit of information on the items that she handed out that are related to this document.
Thank you very much. Good evening. Okay. I had passed out information, and it has a summary of what I'm going to explain, and also is paperclip to the final resolution that you're acting on tonight. The first thing I'd like to point out is that when we began this process with a resolution setting the sale, we did use the dollar amount of $4,825,000. It was always asterisked on our paperwork that that amount was subject to change depending on how the bids came in today. The way the bids came in today, it changed that amount to $4,705,000. Okay, so you're going to see information from me that has the dollar amount of $4,705,000, including the resolution that you're going to act upon tonight. Now, the reason for that is because the way the bids come in. The underwriters submit a bid with premium that they receive from investors as they are pre-selling the bonds. So if they are generating more premium and they give us that premium, what we do is we downsize the amount of bonds for fulfilling the same purposes. Okay, so that's what's going on here. So just some background as to what we're doing. We're borrowing money basically for three purposes. Number one, for the water utilities elevated storage tank, and that's approximately $2.2 million of it. Second thing is we're combining it with a refinancing of the Water Utilities 2007 revenue bonds that have a principal balance of $2,325,000, and they're outstanding at 4.4%. We're at a call date, which means that the city can stop that interest as of May 1st, and you sell new bonds at a lower rate to pay off that $2,325,000, and there's some savings there. So we put it together with the elevated storage tank. Makes sense, saves a extra issuance of bonds. And the third thing is that whenever we're selling revenue bonds, because revenue bonds are not supported by a tax levy pledge, so as part of the security to the bondholders, there is what's called a reserve account. The reserve account has to meet certain standards, and there's a number of tests that are all part of federal arbitrage law. But when we, for the refunding, of course, that reserve wouldn't go up because we're saving money. But because we've added a project, the elevated storage tank, there's going to be a little bit more debt service. So therefore, we have to contribute more to that reserve. So this financing does that. It does the reserve, it does expenses of issuance, and it refinances, and it provides money for construction. So we're doing everything with one financing. So in order to do that, we prepare to enter the municipal bond market. We do that with the coordination of legal documents with your bond counsel, which is Quarles and Brady. The other thing we do is prepare a booklet, and this is a big booklet. This is called an official statement. This goes out to the marketplace. It's also used for the bond rating process, and this booklet has a lot of information about the water utility, about the city. It has the water utilities audit. It has the entire resolution that, by the way, is now the draft resolution, not the one that you're acting on tonight. And that is a lot of information that goes out to the marketplace. And we do that not only to secure a good bond rating and provide the information to Moody's, but also to gather as much interest as we can from the underwriters so we get some good bids for you. So in order to get those bids, in addition to this, and that's also in here, is what's called an official notice of sale. That's a document that goes out separate from this that says the city of Sheboygan is going to have a bond sale. here's the rules for you to bid on it, here's how you can bid on it, and the bids were taken this morning at 10 o'clock. So with that, in terms of the final sale results, the first great news, which you have heard already, is that Moody's has reaffirmed the water utility's AA2 bond rating. Okay, that's a very high grade rating. It is the same rating as the city has, a AA2. Although both of the methodologies that are used are very, very different. So I hate to use the word coincidence because it's not a coincidence that they're the same, because there is a great deal of the city of Sheboygan in addition to the water utilities information that goes into that rating process. But there is total different, what we call methodology, used by Moody's to come up to that AA2. Okay, so that is quite an accomplishment. We received 6 bids this morning, and that is a lot of bids. And Sheboygan is always very popular in the bond market. You know, every time I appear before you, we have 8 bids, 10 bids. This is a different type of financing. And these are what's called non-bank qualified, which means banks are not interested in this type of a security. So to have 6 accounts is a great accomplishment. The winning bidder, the name of the winning bidder is called Hilltop Securities. And they bid this out of Cincinnati, Ohio. So we did get a variety of bids from different places. The true interest rate is a 2.92%, okay? And that interest rate does include all expenses associated with the financing. We asked the underwriter to include all of those expenses so that they will be responsible for paying the fees, and they know that, so they built that into that interest rate. And the actual savings, okay, the part that we can identify separately, the refinancing of the 07 bonds, okay, that's in dollars, $228,377, and that occurs between 2019 through 2027. And then we also assess that on a present value basis, okay, and the rule that is followed by Government Finance Officers Association is to determine if you have a viable refunding. Is that should be at least 3%. Okay, so you have 8.46%. So you have indeed a very viable refinancing. And that is a net number, as I mentioned. It does include all expenses. So on March 1st, all of the money comes into the water utility. And then money is segregated by some goes into that reserve account. The project account for the elevated tank is deposited, and then the other money goes into what's called their special redemption fund, because it is going to be used then on May 1st to pay off the 2007 bonds. Okay, so the resolution that you're acting upon tonight contains information about all the other revenue bonds that are outstanding, because all of the revenue bonds that the water utility has outstanding, which is 2 safe drinking water loans and now 3 bond issues in the municipal bond market, so all 5 of them have to be referenced in every resolution that's adopted. And that's why you see the word supplementing, okay, because it's always going back to the other ones. And every one of those bond issues has the same security to the bondholders. There's none that are more senior than the other one. So all of them are on what's called parity. So it's very important that the documents are drafted in such a way and have the strength they do, because as I mentioned, they don't have a tax levy behind them, but what is analyzed is how much what's called net income or net revenues from the utility, which is strictly generated through their rate base. This document, this resolution, requires that it's at least 1.2 times the debt service on all 5 issues. Well, right now it's over 4 times, so that's how strong of a coverage that the bondholders are getting. And that's the reason why you got 6 bids, and that's the reason why you have the AA2 bond rating. Okay, so anyway, that's what the resolution includes. And yeah, the resolution itself, I make reference on this summary page as to where you can find certain things, and I know the resolution is 50 pages long because we copied them all, so I do know that. But the easiest way, if you do want to look at them, is if you take the document and start from the back and taking the last page and counting it as page one and go back 7 pages. That's where all the information is. From that point, the last 7 pages has all this information that I'm talking about. It has the repayment schedule, the pricing schedule. It has the bid tab, but I see you do have a handout with that separately that shows the 6 bids. And there was quite a range in those bids, and from the best bid to the highest bid. So, you know, that's where we can find all the final sale results. But what I did do on the second and third page of my summary is just to show you how the $4,705,000 issue looks. I have it on the second page at the top. Okay, so that's for all these purposes. Then I split them apart. On the bottom is the portion of that $4,705,000 that belongs to the elevated tank and the reserve. Okay, so you can see that amount there, $2,535,000. And then on the next page is strictly the portion that belongs to the refinancing of the revenue bonds. And it does get a little confusing because under coupon you'll see 4%, but the true interest rate for this is 2.55, and the reason how you get there is the fact that there's $155,000 of premium that's coming to the city, which means you don't have to borrow $155,000 more. See, so you're netting it out. You're paying more on the interest side, but less on the principal side. So that's how it nets it down to the 2.55. So that savings comparison is at the bottom, taking that final debt service at the top, and then comparing it to the 2007 bonds, and there's your net final savings numbers that I was referring to on the front page. Okay.
Are there any other additional questions for Carol? Carol, thank you very much for all the work you did on this on our behalf.
Great. Well, thank you.
Is there any other discussion from the floor? See, now will the clerk please call the roll?
Ayes.
Motion passes.
Thank you very much.
Who works to take care of them?
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Carol.
Thanks.
Moving on, item 5.3 is RC number 226 of 1718 by the Public Safety Committee, to whom was referred resolution number 125 of 1718 by Alderperson Drawn, authorizing the purchasing agent to enter into a contract for the purpose of 5 Police Department patrol duty Ford Police Utility Interceptor all-wheel drive vehicles, and recommends passing the resolution. Alderperson Drawn.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Looking for a motion to accept and adopt and pass the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Yes, aye or no?
Yes, aye or no. 13 ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.4 is RC number 227 of 1718 by the Public Works Committee, to whom is referred direct referral resolution number 129 of 1718 by Alderperson Wolf, authorizing advertising for bids in the 2018 capital improvements projects, and recommends passing the resolution. Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to accept and adopt and pass the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll? Motion passes. Moving on to general ordinance. Item 6.1 is general ordinance number 35 of 1718 by Alderpersons Holshue and Schneider, creating new voting wards in the city of Sheboygan. Alderperson Holshue.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I ask to suspend and pass the ordinance.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion? Under discussion, Alderperson Bellinger.
Can we just let the public know why it's being suspended?
I'll read directly from the document. Suspension of council rules is requested in order to pass this ordinance on first reading so as to allow the new wards to be created in time for the February nonpartisan primary election.
Thank you.
Is there any other discussion? Will the clerk please call the roll? Motion passes. Item 6.2 through 6.4 will be referred to various committees. And then moving on to other matters received after the agenda was published, I'll turn it over to City Attorney Chuck Adams.
7.1 is an RO by the City Clerk submitting various license applications for the period ending June 30, 2018, December 31, 2018, and June 30, 2019.
That'll be referred to the Law and Licensing Committee.
7.2 is an RO by the Director of Planning and Development submitting a summary of the review of the Sheboygan Municipal Armory proposals received as a result of the request for proposals due January 3, 2018.
That'll be referred to Finance and Personnel. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you, Mayor. I guess the concern that I have with both, it's not a concern, but a point of process with both 7.2 and 7.3 is that these are matters of great public interest, I believe. And as there's going to be a need for a full discussion, it seems that it would make more sense to refer these matters to a committee of the whole meeting. And so I'm looking at, as I say, both 7.2 and 7.3 for more thorough discussion and then a referral to the council. And so I would make that motion to refer, and I don't know if I can do 7.3 at the same time.
We should read 7.3, then you can make your motion.
All right. So 7.2, I need to refer to Committee of the Whole, and I'm thinking of a February 12th meeting, which is a Monday night at 6 p.m.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. And we'll move on to 7.3, which is resolution number 134 of 1718 by Alderperson Drawn and Born, authorizing the city staff to negotiate a developer's agreement between the city of Sheboygan and Scott Crawford, Inc. for the redevelopment of the former armory site. Referring to Finance and Personnel. Except
and again, I would move to refer this instead to Committee of the Whole.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion passes. And the last item is a contemplated closed session. Alderperson Wolf.
Thank you, Mayor. I make a motion to convene in closed session under the exemption provided in Section 18.85 sub 1 sub E, Wisconsin stats, where competitive and bargaining reasons require a closed session related to discussion and negotiating strategies between Aurora Healthcare and the Village of Kohler, negotiations on office space lease for temporary relocation of City Hall staff and possible sale of the public property in the expansion of the Sheboygan Business Center.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. I'd like the clerk to please call the roll for closed session. Motion passes. We'll take a short recess of 3 minutes and also advise our viewers at home that we'll be adjourning in closed session. So this will end our transmission for this evening.